Hello and welcome to Rotorua today for this match Italy versus Tonga on the 10th of September 2011, the second match of the day. I am joined by Richard Jones. Yes, hello Ian. I probably forgot to mention my name is Ian Flemming, but we won't go into that. So, obviously, we've just had USA versus Canada in Chicago. USA taking the win at the last minute of play, 28 points to 25. It was quite an interesting match, but we'll talk about that later on. We're here today now to talk Italy and Tonga. Who do you think will be victorious today, Richard? I forgot my name there, didn't you? But right. Well, I think Tonga have got quite a strong squad. You know, they got Hatora on the wing now. They've also, but Italy have got, you know, more experience. Bergamasco, they got Andrea Masi, and they're starting the young goer at wing at fly half now. So probably is going to be quite an interesting match. Good start by Tonga. Good more formed. Next match, we've got two more matches today. We've got South Africa versus Russia later on in North Shore. Carl Roberts and some other guy, John Peacock, I think. Obviously we know who Carl Roberts is. And then we've got later on in Dunedin, we've got Ireland versus the Aussies. So that's going to be the best match of the day, I think. They're deciding to run. So Sia Mazi. It's turned over by Italy once again. Garcia puts the boot for Bergamasco to chase, but Mara gets there first. I don't know what Mara's doing now. Oh! That was really close by Tonga. They're cutting it close now. They're under pressure. Yeah, why would he run towards the post to kick at the post? That's what I don't understand. He could have kicked from where he was. Well, dangerous Tongans are. They don't know. Trying to fool Italy, but they're not fooling Italy now. Gower! Gower's gone round. Oh, he's slowing down for some reason. Semenzato waits a bit, goes for the cross kick, but Torres there to call for the mark. Obviously the World Cup kicked off yesterday with New Zealand and Japan. That was a tremendous match, 139 points to 16 in Auckland. I bet the All Blacks fans were happy with that. Obviously New Zealand have got the home advantage in every single game they're going to play. Gower picks. He kicks it back downfield. No scores yet. There's only a score for, well, Italy are a much better side than Tonga. But Tonga have been playing well in their tournament against Fiji and Samoa. They came victorious. But you didn't know that, Rich? No, I didn't know that, pal. Obviously, you know, Italy have got more experience playing with bigger sides than Tonga, so they should come victorious today. But, you know, I don't like some of the Italians, I gotta give it to you. Bergamasco particularly gets on my tits. I don't know if you're allowed to say that, but he particularly irritates me. Particularly. Say it. Don't fucking start now, Flemby. We're not supposed to be taking the piss out of each other, but we like doing it anyway. It's the mood of things. Canal! He's going for the line. Perugini. Illy getting even closer now. Del Favre goes down. Semenzato. They've got numbers if they can use them. Gower gives it a Massey. Just short of the line. Oh, Zanny, what is he doing? Simon Zato puts it back to Bergamasco. Great offloading, great passing, great hands by Italy. Yeah, they're warming up a bit now. You can see. Oh, he goes for the drop kick, and he's got it. 3 points after 10 minutes of the playing. Simple drop goal. Simple drop goal. Italy like to take the lead, and hopefully they're hoping they will stay there. He gives it to Canal, back inside to Garcia, who goes down. Semenzato, Mara now. The Tongan fullback. Well, if he has time to stop and wait for options, then Italy have got to wake up a bit. It's a kick downfield. Tau is there now. He's gotta beat the Italians. He's gotta boot it now. Relieves pressure for Tonga, but I think that's out on the full. Why or why did he kick? He had space there. I gotta say it right. He had space. If he's listening to this now on a replay, you had space. You shouldn't have booted it. Barberi goes into the scrum half position. Del Fava tries to pick it up. Italy now, come on. They've got great players. Mara. Mara decides to run, which then he should have kicked. Yeah, I don't know what they're doing at the moment. It's a bit silly. It's a word that people in Tonga use. Silly. Tonga very physical squad, but not as physical as Italy. Garcia goes for the try. And 2 minutes, or 3 minutes after the drop goal, Gonzalo Garcia follows it with the try. Simple 5 points. Well, it was inevitable, wasn't it, Dejan? Look, he sees the gap. Mara's too late, he didn't spot him in time. And yeah, thank you for your opinion, Rich. Don't start with me now, Flemmy, right? I fucking knock your block off on flipping live commentary. It's obviously the third match of the... Oh, did you figure that all by yourself? Did you? Okay, cool it now, will she? The third match of the World Cup. There's a lot of matches to go. About 37 matches to go. It's going to take quite a long time. Marzi picks up but runs it into touch for some reason. Now it's a line out for the Italians. Semenzato decides to put the boot in. Mara goes round again. He's not going straight. And he passes to no one. What is he doing? Yeah, I think the Tongans haven't quite woken up to what's going on at the moment. Garcia there. And that was a penalty to Italy. So, it normally says that whoever is victorious in the first half will probably win the game. It depends which teams they're actually playing. And it depends what the scoreline is. So if the scoreline 20-0 at the first half, it's obvious that team is going to win. If it's 20 points to 19 in the first half, then, you know, either way. It's a pass out to Gower. I think it was a temptation to dump him there, but he didn't quite get it in because Gower's a big boy. Semenzato decides to wait and Perugini picks it up. This could be the second try for Italy. No, it's a penalty instead. I think they're going to kick it this time. They won't. Might even go for the punt again. You never know. No, he's going to give it to Bergamasco for the kick. No, sorry, Gower. Even. Tommy Bergamasco was doing the goal kicking. It's not a very far kick, is it, for him? Gower. Simple 3 points for Italy now. After 15 and a half minutes of play, Tonga yet to score. Oh, did you see that? Did you? We can all see that, Ian. Thank you for your sarcasm again, Rich. Gives it to No, it's an interception by Zani. And now it's heating up. Italy getting most possession, most territory of the game so far. Mara decides to run it again. Taken down at the halfway line. A Foca. Tau. It's a break for Artura. He's gonna go all the way. Oh, it's inevitable for a try by you. About time to. He is a tremendous, tremendous athlete, a tremendous player, and he's just scored for his country. It was a lovely break through the number 5 and 7. They didn't see that coming. He could have passed, but well, he didn't need to really. He's got the speed, he's got the stamina to get there. End of story. Goodbye. The end. Try. Yeah, it hurts. Cool it now, Flem. Right. Another simple kick for him as well. Another, there's no been very complex kicks in this game so far. There's normally a halfway kick or something from one of the teams. Not yet. Simple passes from the Tongan side, but it's turned over by Italy. Now Gower. Seminzata. Gelden Heise. Down at the moment. It's good passing from Italy, except for that last one. Canal gives it back to Gower. A bit of a forward pass there, I think. The ref hasn't spotted it. That's probably because there's no ref on the field. He's invisible. This game's crap. Bergamasco tries the offload but sees that there's Tongans in the way. Red sea of brown bodies. Not being racist or nothing. It's actually because they're all brown. No, I'm not shouting racist comments, I'm just saying. Hang on a minute! He's at it again, slows down because of his stamina. A Foca. This could be another try for Tonga here. Lopetti! Oh, and he's given a penalty away again. Jeepers. And now Gower's gonna boot it back into the Tongan half, but it doesn't quite reach the touchline. Tonga will have another break at this. Lopetti. Lopetti's through! Oh, could have been Hatora for a second try there. Tonga woken up now. Gotta give it to him. Woken up. But it is another turnover. Charged down. Puts less of a boot on it. La Tuimo. He's making a run. It's quite an interesting match so far. Out now to Tau. They've got numbers. Nah! Why, oh why, did he knock it on? Because... Do you want to know why, Rich? Do you want to know why? Because he tried to catch the ball, but he dropped it. Alright, Flemmy. See, I can have a bit of sarcasm as well, people are watching. It's more of a comedy than a commentary. Foca. tries to go through there, but the Italians had different ideas. Latu, also great tackle there from Gower, or was it Semenzato? I'm not sure. Tuimo gets out of two tackles, tries the offload, and that made him lose the ball to Italy. Gower. It's a great kick from Gower. From right. Right in there, 22. Or the 10 even, whatever you want to say. Tonga now. More running from both teams now. More, less of the kicks from far distances. They wanna show the other side what they've got. It's the first game for both teams, and they figured, what the hell? See where it goes. A Fike breaking through the tackle there. A Hotain. It's just picking and driving now, picking and driving for Tonga. They could actually. They've got numbers. Can they use them? Mara! He's got Lopetti, he's got Atora. Too much passing. Tackled into the touchline. Semenzato gives it to Gower. Now it's in the hands of Garcia. The try scorer. No shit. Gower now. Oh, you see, Gower is kicking in the wrong places at the wrong time. He could have ran that. He should have taken the tackle without making Tonga. Here it is. Tonga again breaking through the lines. Tau. Oh, it's another turnover ball for Italy. They've been having so many turnovers, they should be having so many more tries, they should be having so many more points. But it's not working for them. And now they've called the mark. Be honest, they don't need to call any marks. There was no Tonga there. He could have had so many options. But he goes for the mark. Just to cool the game off a bit. Now Tonga are taking it again. What is the point? Vaca, the number 8, goes through. So say a Mazi. It's waking up for Tonga now. Vaca. Hafoka. Gives it to Fatani. Oh, it's just his temptation to dump him again there. Same person. There must be some history or something. Canal! Just a bit of a buzz in the Autumn Internationals when Canal came on against Wales. He scored two tries. And Wales just beat them 26-14. And now it's a great step from the Tongan. He's got the pass outside. Yes, he gives it to Seya Marcy. It's going to go all the way. And at the 30th minute of play, Tonga score their second try. Oh, genius. It was a step, a pass and a run. That's all it took. Absolute brilliance. Set up and finished by Seya Marcy. Yeah, he's been a wonderful talent for Tonga over the past years. And now he's really flourishing in the World Cup. Hopefully Tonga will go far with him. Obviously Tonga's next match is a big one. It's Wales. After what Wales did in the Autumn Internationals, it's going to be quite hard for Tonga. Obviously it's fantasy internationals now, not the real ones. The real ones were shit. They played Italy, New Zealand, South Africa and Fiji. But gives a pass to Latu. Latu's making a run. It's the pass to Lopetti. Not so lucky. Carry on, Norwich. Yeah, we haven't seen much of Bergmaas for today. Be pretty honest, no. He's a wonderful talent, but his attitude wrecks. He needs to calm it down. Just go through me, man. Well, Tonga's next match is Wales. It's going to be quite a tough, but Italy. Italy's next match is Fiji, so they got quite... Tonga's not the easiest team, but they're not the hardest team either. Fiji are a little bit harder than them. But, it's going to be alright, I suppose. It's a line-out from the halfway for Italy. Now, let's see if they can get a try before the whistle goes for half-time. Tonga leading at the half now. Yeah, what was I saying before? Oh, what was I saying? Oh, yeah, I'm fucking trying to remind me. I don't know what you were saying, pal. You know, you got such an idiot mind. Alright, listen, Flemming, right? Fucking Flemming, huh? Lopetti. Oh, yes, he's been a tremendous. I think you were talking about, if I'm right, the scores. Oh, hang on! Yeah, the scores, I was saying about, if Italy could have kept it at 13-0, it probably would have been inevitable that they would have won. But, it could be anyone at this point because Tonga are leading 1 point. Oh, and that should have been a penalty there. Been of way too. That's a tremendous kick by Tau, but it's picked up by Marcy. It's passed out to Bergamasco. I think that's his first touch of the game. Gower. It's Namara. Quite quiet now. Rotorua tries to break through the lines, but the Italians have a different schedule. Right, enough for that shit though, right? Fucking me off. Latu gives it back inside to Tau. Latu again. Lopetti. Hang on a minute. Another turnover for Italy. They're not. It's quite irritating how many turnovers Italy have had, and they haven't done nothing with the ball. They've either kicked it or lost it again. Tonga want another try before the half. There's 20 seconds left. Lopetti! Slowing down. Stamina button. What is that stamina button on about? Holton tries to go through the lines. It could be a one more try for Tonga. Tau. Moves it to the outside. Marcy. Back inside to Latu for the drop goal. Doesn't quite get it. Just out wide. And that is a tremendous half of rugby. Well, 14-13 at the half. Rich, if you want to run through some of the stats. Why, have you just got autism as a man? Autism? You mean dyslexia? I think you've got a bit of autism. Rich, yeah, right. Cool it, Flemmy. 2-1 against Italy. Tonga, both kickers have been on form. It's one of everything for Italy. They got one conversion, one penalty, one drop goal. But we're going to return now, aren't we? Rotorua is about to start the second half. Let's hope we see some more tries from Italy. Only one try in the first half. Gonzalo Garcia was the try scorer for Tani. Intercepts Garcia's offload. Tau offloads to Tumo. It's another breakdown for Tonga. What's going to happen? Tau goes for a long drop kick. Doesn't... What? See, I'd like to see Tonga win, but the way they're playing at the moment, you know, dropping goals from flipping almost the halfway line, they're not going to get it. They know they're not going to get it. They just want to keep composure, keep their running, and in the end, they'll come through with a win. Yeah, I do agree with you there. There's Bergamasco again being greedy. He could have passed that out. He's a good passer. He's a good winger. Pass the freaking ball out, and mate, you might score. Don't be a greedy. You don't like Bergamasco, do you? I've got to be honest with you. He wrecks me. He does my fucking skull in. That's all I got to say. His face, you know. Oh, you're so funny, Rich. Cool it now, Flemming. He's on a bit gay. Oh, sorry. Nothing exciting happened yet. Gower freezes with the Tongan freight trains coming at him. And it's another interception by Tonga. Can they make something of it now? Latu, he's through. He's got Mara. Oh, he couldn't. He should have passed it. Again, a pass is all I need for a try. That's all I need to do. Doesn't matter if you score it. At least your team, and your country scores it. But yeah, but we've just seen a drop goal now. Pointless. They could have scored. Honestly, I don't see a point of drop goals. Fair enough, it gets to 3 points, but if the other team score a try, you fucking lost, haven't you? Unless the other team is really bad. And what is he doing? What a knob. My grandmother actually could have not done that. Pass a ball and then you clip the touchline. How pathetic is that? You're in world rugby now. You shouldn't be playing for a country if you can't. Here he is, Bergamasco, bang, tackled, down to the ground, have that, you ugly Shrek-faced fuck. Here we are, here's a better one, he gets closer up to the line, because of passes, there's more passing going on. Marcy, Andrea Marcy. I got a lesson for you, Bergamasco, pal. Don't go running into someone because you're not going to go past them, here. Especially if they're bigger than you, and everyone's bigger than you. Especially Andrea Marcy. Andrea Marcy sees the gap. He doesn't need to pass it. And probably if he did pass it, they wouldn't have scored. But I can see you don't like Bergamasco, but you know, there's going to be a little complaints if you carry on slagging off. The chair's a bit wobbly, so what's wrong, Rich? I need a shit. This chair shit. What's that? I don't know what's going on. Right, I see what's happening. Just go back. Excuse me for a moment, folks. Concentrating on that try by Andrea Marcy. We should have been shouting our heads off, like, "Way!" But it was a tremendous try, Marcy, if you're watching. That makes Italy 20. We're really bothered because, you know, freaking riches on it. Right. You don't need to say it. They heard. They heard. What, bitch? Cool. No, I'm not fucking cool. Where can you start? No, right, Flemmy. It's okay. Richard having a panic attack here. No! I'm not! Latu. No, oh, Latu, you know you fuck. No, Latu! He's running! Concentrate on the game now, Rich. Huh? You've had a rant. That's enough. Great pass into... Oh, Cecilia Mass. He's going for it again! He's slowing down. Stamina button. What is a stamina button? Tau! And now he levels the scores. He could have had a try. Look, you got Mara, you got Hafoka, and you've got Marcy coming in from his other wing. So why not pass it and actually score a try? I do agree with you there, Rich, for a change. Right, listen now, right? Cool it. Sorry. Tau puts a tremendous boot downfield. Oh! Gets him right in the 22. Same in Zotto. So now... Benvenutui. Fuck, whatever his fucking name is. Poker feeds to the scrum and it's collapsed by Italy. It's a penalty to Tonga. They're gonna try and take the lead again. Oh, the wind caught that. That was a simple kick. Simple kick missed. Yeah. I do agree with you, Ian. I think my grandmother could have got on her knees. So it was quite a pathetic kick, but they're coming back into field now. That's what I love about Tonga. They try their best to get as much points as they can. Marcy. Andrea Marcy gets Italy back up to the halfway. So Mazzotto goes for the crossfield kick from the ruck, but Benvenuti, or whatever his name is, we'll just call him number 14, right? Because it can't say his name. End of story. If you are bored of some of these matches, we have got chicken nugget. Well. Another try. This time from Kevlimoni Mara. I said his name. Yes, I did. I won't repeat it because I can't. But there is more games. We've got tons of games. We've got the whole World Cup coming on the internet. On Chicken Nugget Rugby. So if you're bored of this match, just go on to one of the other matches that are available. Different commentators, different games, whatever you want. That's another try we've missed that we didn't make much fuss about. That was a tremendous step, tremendous try. We are quite bored in this commentary box. Canal. Could this be another try for Italy? Oh, they've given Tonga a penalty. Oh. It's another penalty given away. Why? Why? I think it's the rugby field in Rotorua. I think it's whoever's on the other side now will win. Because Italy were getting more penalties when they were starting on that side. Now Tonga getting more penalties. What's going on? Geldenhuis. And we're back. Zanny. Gives it to Gelenhuis again, who goes down in the tackle. Semenzato waits. Where they decide to pick and go instead. I need a proper shit now. Hold on. I'll be, I do need a shit. I don't know. Rich needs a shit as well. No, I do actually. We haven't had our morning shit this morning, so. That's probably why we're not concentrating on the game much. I don't think the audience want to know. There he is again. But, sorry. Sorry, Rich. Carry on. Bergamasco. I hate watching him play. Fair enough, he's a good player. Oh, he passed it for a change. Didn't go far though, did it? Should have ran it that time. Obviously, in your eyes, everything he does is wrong. Pretty much. My grandmother's tour could play better than what he does. Your grandmother's sounds like a saint. Barbieri. Down in the tackle. Zanny picks it up, tries to run through. Down! Perugini gets stuck in the ruck. Tries to go through it, but Tonga have other plans for him. Garcia tries the offload. Oh my gosh. Afoka. Gives it to Tau. That's another long drop goal. Why, oh why, did he drop goal it? Now Andrea Marcy's picked it up. When Andrea Marcy picks it up,
there's trouble.
Canal. Semenzato. Barbieri. Now Italy have a chance. No, they don't have a chance. Do you know why? Let me have a guess. I'll take a wild guess. Bergmaster. You're correct. You are correct there, boy. Marsh is going to blow up like Mount Vesuvius in a minute.
Oh.
That is disgusting, boy. That is absolutely vile. We've got a squeaky chair as well. That's what the noise is if you're in. It's not me farting. Oh, there's your whistling laugh going again there, Rich. I can't even do it. Semenzato. Gives it to Parise. Parise tries to break. Good captain for Italy. He's probably been the best captain he's ever captained Italy. He's hoping to captain them to a World Cup final, but I can't see it happening at the way Italy are playing at the moment. And the next match, Fiji, is going to be quite hard because it's Fiji for a start. Quarter finalist in the last World Cup. But didn't do too well against Wales. Wales beat them 87-0 in the Autumn Internationals. Lopetti. It's going to be more for Tonga. Tau. Puts the kick through. Bergamasco picks it up. Oh, what? I can't. From now on, every time Bergamasco gets the ball, we're going to be quiet, aren't we? No, we're not. Why? Because he is, right, as we can see, there is a sub coming on, or Quera coming on for Goa, but where was I? We're not going to say his name anymore, right? We're not even going to speak his name anymore. Because he's a dick. If you're listening to this now,
I hate you.
Just cool it. What? You need to cool it, Rich. It's not very nice. If he does hear this, he's going to go nuts. Oh, it's another missed. Another missed penalty for Tonga. They won't be happy. They want at least 10 points between to secure a win here today at Rotorua, the third match of the Rugby World Cup. on the 10th of September 2011. Next year the world's gonna end, innit? You hope? Oh, and there it is again. I have a stroke when someone runs a ball into touch. Like that. What's the point? He's just giving it the line out right now. Here's the try. Maybe not. A bit overcooked by a Quera there. They better make some move quick, otherwise Tom are going to slam them. Mara puts a big boot down back into Italy's 22. Oh, hang on. Tuetti dives for protection on the ball. Tau. Marcy now. Andrea Marcy gives it to Zani. Semenzato, pass. He kicks it for some reason. This is why they're not scoring. Kicks. As well. In the wrong places at the wrong time. Mara! Oh, great pass to Sasea Marcy. Hatora. The fucker gives it out now. Vakia. Vakia even. Hotain. Oh, great step. What's going to happen? Tau. Replacing Mikiliki. At 10. Mikiliki hasn't come on yet. And might not come on. Never know. Semenzato turns it over. Puts the kick in for Tonga. Didn't go far. Caught in the ruck, I think. Here comes a drop kick from Tau. Nope, misses again. It's going to be another dropkick, I think. He's coming back in for it. Oh, that was even worse than the first time. Canal. Oh, I'm desperate for a shot. It's unbelievable. Aquera puts the kick down. Mara runs it. That's what they want. They want the 3 points. They're desperate for the 3 points. It's unbelievable how much they want the 3 points. They were injured the first time, buddy. Right? Listen, stop flaming it up now, right? They're trying to get closer for this drop kick. It's going to go over. It's going to be after a hot 10 gets it over for them. And there's about 8 minutes left for this game. You can see who's actually going to win it today. Pretty obvious now. I can't see it looking back the way they've been playing. Aquera ready to restart the match. Lopetti. Oh, it's a great gap. Oh, again, I know, again, isn't it? I know. Just let me speak. Alright, no, I will not let you. Yes, you're gonna let me. No, I'm not gonna let you speak.
Yes, you're gonna let me speak.
Atora. Beats Bergala. Don't speak his name. You're not going to speak his name, are you? No, you're not. You're not going to speak his name, are you? Ian, say it. Because of you, Richard, we've missed another try. And it was the most pathetic try. Tonga missed. Oh, that's tremendous. Here it is, watch. It's the pass to nobody. Goes back. He misses the pickup. Zani comes in. Oh, I can't look at him. I can't look at his face. He's an ugly trout, isn't he? If he misses this, then he's going to have to start all over. Because he's crap. Oh, Jesus Christ, what was that? Flipping. Dan Carter could have done that by just flicking the ball, right? That's how good Dan Carter is. You could have flicked the ball and that would have happened. And if they haven't, that didn't just happen. I'm being quiet. Yeah, good. Don't good me. I'm good in you. No, you can't good me, right? Because Mars is running now, and you have to talk. Right, I'll talk about the game. You shut up. Del Father sticks it where it hurts in for Tonga. They want another try now. They want to win this.
Yeah, they do.
Trying everything. But Vaki, or Vaka even. I thought it was Vaki earlier. Fucking hell. How many Vakas are on the fucking team? Afoka. Aho Tyne. Is a pass now to Latu. Oh, is it going to be? It could have been, but it wasn't. Oh, and they've given a penalty away. Just short of their own try line. Aquera is going to kick it out. Oh, it's been quite an intense last 10 minutes, isn't it, Dewis? Yeah. Is that all you got to say? Yeah. That's all you got to say is yeah. Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, shut up. You say pretty much shut up then. Oh, and that could only have been made in Rotorua. There's three and a half minutes left of this match now. Marcy, what is he doing? For Christ's sake. Drop goal from halfway, it's not going to happen, is it? Mara, he gives it to Hattora. He's going to go all the way. Yes, he is. He's going to go. No, he's not. I'm going to make a big fuss of this last try. Tau, Latu. Oh, Sasea Marcy. Hafoka. Into the hands of Tau. Oh, this is it. This is it. Latu. Try. Oh, brilliant. Brilliant by Tonga. And I think we can see who the winner is today. Yes, well, obviously, because they got a higher score than me. You phlegm fliss. Fuck. I think we've fallen out, haven't we, Rich? No, we'll make up the next time we commentate together. No, last kick of the day, because I'm desperate for a kick. Oh, he misses. What a crap kick that was. He's a scrum half, he shouldn't be kicking. It should be the 10 who'd be kicking. What a sight. Queerer. Restarts probably for the last time, unless there's been another score for both teams. Oh. Richard walking around. I need to chip so bad. Marcy. Semenzato to Parisi. Not long left now. They can't win. They can't win. There's no way they're going to win in 35 seconds. No chance in hell. Castro Giovanni. Down. Oh, there's 10 seconds. Oh, now there's 10 seconds left. Canal! Burley must go. There's 80 minutes on the clock. They want one more try. But they can't win now. They can't possibly win. There's no way. Semenzato, Garcia. Oh, advantage Tonga. This is it. It's just a kick out now. That's all they need. Kick it out. He's kicked it downfield. But it is a penalty advantage, so they will end the game there. And Tonga victorious. It was a good game of rugby. I have to say, I'm desperate for the shit. Well, we're going to say goodbye to Richard now, because he needs a shit. So, I'll see you, Rich. Thank you for commentating today. I'll go through the stats. 4 tries. Oh, hang on. We'll have a look at the replay. There's the kick. Don't know why we want to see the replay of that. Well, there we go. 4 tries to 3. 3 out of 4 conversions for Tonga. 2 out of 3 for Italy. no penalties, but one out of one penalty for Italy, and 3 drop goals to 1. Brilliant. Jesus. Tonga have got probably secured themselves a good place on the leaderboard. And the next game we have, I'm going to hand you over now to North Shore with Carl Roberts and John Peacock. Thank you for watching. Good night.